At this point, I think it's finally about time SwiftUI would give us a progress button. Don't know what I'm talking about? Well, take a look at these beauties. Yes, I made these so you don't have to. And yes, I'm giving them away for free so you can add them into your SwiftUI project ASAP. Let's see them in action. The progress button is brought to you by Beyond Code, my private invite-only community where I teach SwiftUI and we kind of build all of these things out. You have access to all of the source code that I'm using to build better apps in SwiftUI. So go ahead and check it out. It's at rebeloper.com/community. It's called Beyond Code. Go ahead and apply right now. So what we are going to build out today, and again, this is inside Beyond Code. I'm open sourcing it today is this. So let me just show you kind of this demo project. By the way, the link is in the description for the starter project. Go ahead. It's in the resources. So I just launched this and this progress button is available on iOS and watchOS. So as you can see, it just launched already there, and also on macOS. For some reason, I couldn't make it work on tvOS. Go ahead and comment down below if you find a solution for that. So this is what we are going to build out. Now, this doesn't look that much for a starter, but let's start tapping on these buttons. So there we go. We have this progress button. It's just sliding to the leading part of our button. On the second button we have next, it's sliding to the trailing part of our button, and it's, you know, it's having a label right over there. The upload button, as you might expect, is just going to slide all the way up, and we have a progress view and a text of uploading. And here we go, my favorite, the download button, is just going to slide down, and then we have a progress view. It's linear and it's just going to download stuff up. Of course, all of this is a dummy download, but you get the idea. Now, all of this works also on watchOS and macOS. So let's take a brief look at how it looks like on the watchOS part. So again, saving. And again, this is the same code. There are little restrictions on different OS versions, but basically the same code. And of course, you can take a look at the source code. The link is in the description. Let's take a look at the macOS app right over here. There we go. And then on the next button, saving, there we go, uploading, and then the download button. Okay, so let's just stop all of these because we are just simply going to start off from scratch. And we are going to create a progress button, a custom progress button, because all of these will be available for you to take a look at inside the demo view. And there's also a service, this kind of does the mock data fetch, you know, it's just waiting a lot and updating the progress value. And here is the progress button. Go ahead and download it in the resources. Okay, so right now we have the demo view on instead of the content view. So let's just switch back here. So content view. And by the way, all of this is inside the starter branch of the GitHub repository. I'm also going to commit the final project, what we worked on today. So what I'm going to do is just show this to you on the iOS branch target, but it just should work on all three. Okay, so on the content view, we don't have much, so we have, you know, the basic content view. So what I'm going to do is just actually create a progress button. So progress button, and there we go. We have a lot of initialization options, so let's take a look at them. So I'm going to hit option because then it's not going to use only the most required one. So option and hit return. So the direction, it is up, right, left, and down. It is the direction where the animation will go. For example, the download button, because it's just downloading, it should move the label down, and also the progress view that is going to be changing the label down. So I would just go down with that. But for now, let's just go maybe Let's use down, okay? I believe there's also a default value here, and yeah, that is down, so let me just not use the default one. Let's just go with up, maybe. Okay, or right. Okay, so we're going to right. That's trailing, by the way. Now comes the clip shape. Now, if you're not adding a good clip shape, then yeah, and this is automatically handled by progress button, the actual animation, the label, will kind of crop outside of the background. You will see that we're also going to have a background view. So whenever you create a clip shape, that will encompass all of our buttons. So here, let's just have maybe a rounded rectangle with a corner radius, I don't know, maybe 15, and let's have a style of continuous. Okay, so here comes the fun part. This is kind of only the setup, where the direction, the clip shape, so how it should clip onto, and then if I hit return again, you will see all of this unfold. So here we have our action, and it's going to be this completion is going to be called done. Now, what is this actually? When once you do something here, so we just go service dot do some work, you know, and we are going to add in the progress value. Well, I don't really care about the progress value for now, so I'm just going to add a constant of zero. Once we finished our work, so right over here we do some work, and once we finished, we just go and complete. So we could just do it like so done. Just like that, or because, you know, this do some work has the same completion as our done completion, we can just go ahead and add done right over here. And that's done. This is how you know, okay, this is what I'm working on. This is the action that I want to perform after I tap on the progress button. And once it's done, then just move back. Okay. That's all. We have a progress state. So right over here, we just have is progress, is in progress. So this is a Boolean value. And this will just, well, let's just print it out, is in progress. So this will just, and you can just use this, for example, to enable or disable other elements of your UI. When the progress button is in progress, then just disable it. When it's going to be set to false automatically, then it's just simply going to you know, switch back that. So currently I'm just going to print it out in progress. You can see a real example on the demo view if you choose to, with the in progress. Now, label, progress, and background, these are the views that we want to add in here. So for the label, let's have maybe an actual label with a title of, I don't know, beyond code, because actually that is the community that I just you know, my private community where I took this code. And the system image, well, let's just use house, because yeah, this is our house of you know, iOS developers. Okay, that's great. For the progress, let's keep it simple. Let's have a progress view, and for the background, let's have well, maybe a color of well, let's see how orange would look like. And as you can see, this is really straightforward how to set this up. Of course, I'm not using the in progress. I'm not using the progress value. Go ahead and check it out. The actual, you know, usage of it inside the demo view. So let's stop this and let's build and run on the iPhone simulator. As you can see, we have beyond code. It doesn't look that great. So I'm just going to style it a little bit. So right over here, I'm going to add a padding of maybe, let's just go with horizontal of, I don't know, 32. And then let's have also a little bit of vertical padding of maybe 12, let's see that. And then I'm also going to add a foreground color of white, because yeah, it looks really, really great. The progress view, well, I didn't tap on the button actually, but well, let me just do that for you. There we go. We have our progress button. So it's black. I don't really like that. So I'm going to tint this. So let's just tint this to, I believe white will do. So let's see if it's just going to let us just use white, which is really great, and the background is orange. Let's build and run again, and now it will look really, really well, much better, as you can see. So we have beyond code. Okay, let's just click on it. It's just going to slide away, and as you can see on the console also, you just set it to true and false. Now this is the simplest way of doing this. It's really, really versatile. You can do a lot of progress buttons to your liking. Now, if you did like this progress button, go ahead and check out Beyond Code. This code and many, many others like this is inside my private invite-only community. Go ahead and apply now. It's at rebeloper.com/community. And if you want to take a look at coordinators in SwiftUI, go ahead and check out the video. It's right over here.